Hi, in this video, I will be showing you how to make a few graphs using Excel and SPSS. First, we'll start by making a bar graph. I have my data here, so I'm just going to go here and highlight both my columns. I'll go to Insert and then go to the bars up here. I want the upright bars. And I'll click on the very first one. And then once I have it here, I can select one of these outlooks to include for me the frequencies, which will be the heights of the bars. Next, I will be making a pie chart. Similar steps, I will highlight both columns. I will go to Insert, and then I'll click on the circle. I'll select the very first one. Again, I'm going to select one of the outlooks up here to include for me the relative frequencies within my sectors. Next, for my Pareto chart, I will highlight both columns, right-click, and look for Sort. And then I'm going to select Custom Sort. I'm going to be sorting by number of graduates on the values from the largest to the smallest, and then okay. I'm going to repeat the steps for a bar graph. I'll go to Insert, the upright bars, and then I'll select the very first one. So I'll select any of these outlooks. Next, I will be showing you how to make a time series graph. I have interval data here. So I'm going to create a new column. I'm just going to come over here and highlight that column, right click, and insert a column to the right. So I'm going to call this T. So I'm going to make my 1996 1, and then I'm going to go in steps of 1 for the rest of the cells. So this new column that I've created becomes my new independent variable, or my X variable. So I'm gonna highlight both columns and then click on Insert and then go to the bunch of dots here and then select the one that is connected by straight lines. So this will be what my time series plot looks like. We're gonna talk about how to make a histogram. To be able to make the histogram, I need a column. I'll call that the beans. Now, this column will be my upper class limits or my upper class boundaries. So I have them in one column. And then I will go to data. I'll be using data analysis. And on this list, I will look for histogram. And then OK. In my input range, I'm going to highlight the column, the whole column of my data. I'm going to put that in. Once I have everything in, I'll go to the second box and highlight the column that contains my beans, which is my upper class limits. And then I'm going to come over here and check on cumulative percentage chart output. And then I'll click OK. So I have three graphs over here. The first one I have on the right corner here will be my frequency distribution table. I will be deleting everything in this last row because I don't have anything in that class. So this will be my frequency distribution table with my cumulative frequencies in this column, my frequencies in this column, and my upper class limit in this column. Next, I will look at the graphs here. For the blue bars, I will right click on any of these blue bars and I will click on Format Data Series. And over here, I'm going to change in the gap width, I will drag that all the way. I'll change that to 0. So when I expand this and it's larger, we are going to see right there in the background, the blue graph there will be the histogram. while my red line here will be my ogive or my cumulative frequency curve. If you wanted to see the ogive better, we can right click on the any of the blue bars and hit delete. So it leaves me with just the ogive or the cumulative frequency curve. Next, I will be making a side-by-side bar graph. Here I have my data right here. I have the males in millions and the females in millions. So what I need to do is to, again, highlight both columns. I'll highlight both columns, insert, and pick the bar graph up there. And then select the very first one and choose any of the outlooks here. Next, I'll be making a scatter plot. Now for the scatter plot, I have my X variable in one column, my Y variable or dependent variable in the second column. Notice anytime we're in Excel, we want the X variable in the first column and the Y variable in the second column. I will simply highlight both columns and then go to insert and then click on the bunch of dots and click the first one. So this right here will be my scatter plot. The next set of graphs, I will be showing us how to make using SPSS. So once we are in SPSS, our data is right there in SPSS. I will start by making a dot plot. Now I will go to Graphs, Chart Builder, and then I'll go to the gallery and look for scatter slash dot. So this is the dot plot that I need in this case. So I'm going to drag it over there. And then I'm going to pick up my variable and put it in here. Once I have that, I will just click OK. I have my dot plot showing up in the output window. So my dot plot looks like that. Next, I'm going to go back and make a stem and leaf plot, a box plot, and also show you how to make histogram using SPSS. Here, I will go to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, Explore. I'll put in my variable in the dependent list, and then I will go to Plots. For the plots, I'm going to check the stem and leaf, the histogram, and inside the box plot, I will check the box factor levels together. And then I'll click continue and then OK. So if we look at the output window, all of the graphs will show up here. The very first one I have here, I have my histogram. So that is what my histogram looks like. I can see this is left skewed. The next one I see here is the stem and leaf plot. If I try to flip this also the right way up, I will see that my stem and leaf plot also will be showing that it is also left skewed. Lastly, I have the box plot. The box plot here is upright. So again, you can see here the box plot shows that the distribution is left skewed. And then at the bottom there, we can be able to see a couple of outliers there. Thank you for watching this video.